Hello students, now I am here with your sixth chapter of mathematics, that is indices chapter we are going to study. Now few of these laws and rules and definition etc. I am discussing from book itself, so it will be helpful for you. Say if you are multiplying A with itself up to m factors, then you write it as a to the power m. This chapter is not new, you have done it in your lower classes. So what I said, if a you are multiplying with itself for m times, then it is written as a to the power m. Here a is the base, a is called the base, and here a is called the base, and m is called the index or exponent, or you say it power also. The plural of index is indices. Now always remember that when you raise 0 as power to any number, any base, then the value is 1. A to the power 0 is equal to 1. Similarly, a to the power, any negative power if you take, then that is equal to 1 by a to the power n. These are few important rules you must remember. A to the power minus n is equal to 1 by a to the power n. 3 to the power 0 is equal to 1, 2 by 5 to the power 0 is equal to 1, any base, power is 0, value is 1. Similarly, 2 to the power minus 5, now you see, when you are taking the reciprocal of the base and the power sign will change, 2 to the power 5. Now here, if it is 2 to the power minus, 1 by 2 to the power minus 5, then that will be equal to 2 to the power 5, whose value, now 2 to the power 5 value is 32, so it is written here 1 by 32. What I said, that if it is 1 by 2 to the power minus 5, then that is equal to 2 to the power 5, and this value will be 32. Just the reverse of this one I have said. Now, so what is power actually? When you in the preceding chapter you have studied about thirds and all, so there you have studied nth root of a. Nth root of a is x, then x a to the power 1 by n is equal to x. So here, whenever you are taking the root over of any time, then that is the reciprocal power of the base. So nth root of a means a to the power 1 by n. And when you transfer this power to the other side, then this will get transferred in reciprocal. That is 1 by n. When you transfer to this side, that means you are taking x power, then it will be x to the power n, and it will come as x to the power n is equal to a. As I said, square root of a, last video also I had told you, square root of a means a to the power half, 1 by 2. Fourth root of a means a to the power 1 by 4, and it is called fourth root of a. Similarly, nth root of a means a to the power 1 by n. Now if a to the power 1 by 4 is equal to, if you take x, then a will be equal to x to the power 4. For positive values of a, the value of a to the power 1 by n will be always taken as positive. So square root of 9 is equal to 9 to the power half is equal to 3, since 3 to the power 2 is equal to 9. You know square root of 9 is equal to 3. How it is coming? It is coming that 9, you are writing 3 to the power 2 to the power half, so it is equal to 3 to the power 2 into 1 by 2, so 2 to cancel, 3 to the power 1, and any base, power 1 is the base itself, that is 3. Then cube root of 8, again you can write 8 as 2 to the power 3 to the power 1 by 3, so 3 into 1 by 3 will get cancelled, so it is 2 to the power 1. So that will come later when we will be studying the laws of indices, it will be much clearer. Now for any negative, a is any negative real number and n is an even positive integer, then a to the power 1 by n is not possible, not defined. If what is said, A is any negative real number and n is any even positive number, then A to the power 1 by n is not defined. Like minus 4 to the power half is not defined. Minus 9 to the power half not defined. Minus 16 to the power 1 by 4 not defined. Minus 64 to the power 1 by 6 is not defined. Now, one more important part which will be helpful for you to solve the sums is, suppose A to the power P by Q is there. So it had 1 by Q, A to the power, I can write it as A to the power 1 by Q whole to the power P. That is equal to, or I can write also as A to the power P whole to the power 1 by Q. If I write like this, then it will be A to the power P and its qth root. So it is written qth root of A to the power P. Some examples are given. You can see your book and you can find out, and you can practice also, like 4 to the power 3 by 2. So you can write it as 4 to the power 3 whole to the power 1 by 2. So that is 4 to the power 3 is 64, and its power half, so 8 to the power 2 to the power half. So 8 to the power 2 into 1 by 2, so 2 to cancel, you are getting 8. So like this, some other examples are also given. Now some laws of indices, you should practice all these laws first. A to the power m into A to the power n is equal to A to the power m plus n. You have studied it earlier also. Now as I was saying, this is called product law. A to the power m into A to the power n is equal to A to the power m plus n. Similarly, A to the power m whole to the power n, then power will be multiplied. This is called power law. A to the power m into n. Then A by B to the power n, that is equal to A to the power n by B to the power n. So here the power is shared. Exponent is shared by each term in the factor. Now the second law which I had missed, that is called the quotient law, and it is A to the power m by A to the power n is equal to A to the power m minus n. As I said, it is called quotient law. Same base, if different powers are there and it is divided, then it will be the powers will be subtracted. Similarly, AB to the power n, as we had done here, A by B to the power n, then the power is shared to each term. Here also, AB to the power n, then the power will be shared, A to the power n, B to the power n. A to the power minus n, I have already said, that is equal to 1 by A to the power n. Then A by B to the power minus n, so you can take it as A to the power minus n by B to the power minus n, and then 1 by A to the power n by 1 by b to the power n, then it is equal to b to the power n by a to the power n. N you take out because it is shared by both the terms, then it is coming b by a to the power n. So directly you can do a by b to the power minus n is equal to b by a to the power n. If a to the power m, this is important for solving sums, a to the power m is equal to a to the power n, bases are same on both sides of equality, then powers will be equal. M is equal to n. Similarly, if the powers are same on both sides of equality, then you can equate the base also. A to the power m, like here it is given, A to the power m is equal to B to the power m, then A is equal to B. Powers are equal, then you are equating the bases. P to the power m, Q to the power n into R to the power s. What is happening to the video? R to the power s. Now, other side, it is, if it is equal to P to the power a, Q to the power b, R to the power c, then each values, each base power can be equated if it is in this form. M is equal to a, n is equal to b, s is equal to c. So these are the laws, children, you have to memorize, and then you can proceed for the sums. Few sums I am working out here. You can understand and then you can do it from your book. Like if you have 64 to the power 1 by 3. Now you have to evaluate this value. So how I will do? I will write it as, since here the power is 1 by 3 and denominator is 3, I will always seek the base to be in the power of the of 3. So what I will write? You know 64 is equal to 4 to the power 3. So 4 to the power 3 to the power 1 by 3, then it is equal to, now power law you apply, so it is equal to 4 to the power 3 into 1 by 3, 3 cancelled, so 4 to the power 1, that is equal to 4. So this is your answer. Similarly, if you have 64 to the power 25 whole to the power minus 3 by 2. So first what you will do, you will try to adjust this negative part, negative power. So you have studied it, what it will be? You will take the reciprocal of the base. So it is 25 by 64 whole to the power, how much? 3 by 2. 3 by 2. Now you see power is in fraction and its denominator is 2. So you try to raise the base power as 2. So it will be 5 to the power 2 by 8 to the power 2 whole to the power 3 by 2. So now you can use 5 by 8 to the power 2, then to the power 3 by 2. So what you are getting? That is equal to 5 by 8. Now power law you will apply. So 5 by 8 to the power to the power 2 into 3 by 2. So 2 to cancel, it is coming 5 by 8 to the power 3. So how much it will be? 5 to the power 3 by 8 to the power 3. 5 to the power 3 is 125 and 8 to the power 3 is 512. The next type of questions, like simplify, it is given. Simplify, I am taking up one question. Simplify, it is given that 64 by 125 to the power minus 2 by 3 plus 4 to the power 0 plus 8 to the power 2 by 3, 8 to the power 2 by 3 into 1 by 2 to the power minus 1 into 3 to the power 0, long one, minus 1 by 81 to the power minus half. So we have to do this one. So how I will do? So here, first thing, change the negative part. So I will take the reciprocal, 125 by 64 to the power, it will be 2 by 3, as it is, it will remain. Plus 4 to the power 0 is 1, plus 8 to the power 2 by 3, I will take 2 to the power 3 to the power 2 by 3. 1 by 2 to the power 1, so I will take reciprocal, 2 to the power 1, 3 to the power 0 is 1, and this is again minus 81 to the power 1 by 2. Then I will try to find out in terms of the denominator of the index. So it is 5 to the power 3 by 4 to the power 3. This we had done in the previous part. Okay. Then 2 to the power 2 by 3 plus 1 plus 2 to the power 3 into 2 by 3 into 2 to the power 1. So it is 2, 1 is multiplied, minus here half is there, so 9 to the power 2 to the power half. 9 to the power 2 to the power half. So you have to, it is 5 by 4, I am taking directly 3 to the power 2 by 3, product law I have applied, then plus 1, then here 3 and 3 cancel, so plus 2 into 2 minus 9 to the power 2 into 1 by 2, so 2 cancel. So here 3 cancel. So you are getting 5 to the power 2, that is 25, by 4 to the power 2, that is 16. Here you are getting plus 1 plus 4 minus 9. So what will be the value? So 25 by 16, this is 1 plus 4, 5, minus 9, so that will be 4, so minus 4, so 25 minus 64 by 16, if you take the LCM, then it is equal to 9, 39, with a negative sign, by 16, this is your answer. Actually, from the book, what question was there? I have changed 64 by 125. Okay, then 4 to the power 0 I have taken, then I have taken the other part. So little bit change of question is there, and then I have worked it out. You follow the process, not the answer. Some root over values, like if you have to find out root over of 72, how to get this? So this you write as 6 into 6 into 2 to the power half, that is 6 to the power half, 6 to the power 2 into 2 to the power half. Now you share the power, 6 to the power 2 to the power half into 2 to the power 2 to the power half. So that is equal to 6 to the power 2 into 1 by 2 into 2 to the power half. So this is equal to 6, and 2 to the power half is root 2, so it is 6 root 2. Now if one type of question, suppose 2160, we had discussed it in the rule, so let us practice that. That is equal to 3 to the power a, sorry, 2 to the power a into 3 to the power b into 5 to the power c. Then find out the values of a, b and c, and then calculate 3 to the power a. Well, question is find out a, b and c, and then find out the value of 3 to the power a, 3 to the power a into 2 to the power minus b into 5 to the power minus c. So first, this is second part. First part you have to find out the value. For that you will find out the prime factors of 2160. So you know how to find out the value. 2160, first 2, 1080, then 2, 540, then 2, it is 270, then again 2, 135. Now this is divisible by 3, so 3, 4, 12, 3, 5, 15, 3, 15, then 3, 5. So you are getting 2 is multiplied 4 times, 3 is multiplied 3 times, and 5. So you will write 2160 as 2 to the power 4 into 3 to the power 3 into 5 to the power 1. That is equal to 2 to the power a into 3 to the power b into 5 to the power c. So now you compare, so a will be equal to 4, b will be equal to 3, b equal to 3, and c is equal to 1. So once you get the value of a, b, and c, you have to find out the value asked, that is 3 to the power a into 3 to the power a into 2 to the power minus b into 5 to the power minus c. So that will be 3 to the power a is 4, 2 to the power that is minus 3 into 5 to the power minus c is 1, so minus 1. Now you find out the value. 3 to the power 4, I will change the negative power, so 1 by 2 to the power 3 into 1 by 5. So 3 to the power 4 is 81. 81 into 1 by 8 into 1 by 5. So it is equal to 81 by 40. So this is the answer, second part of the answer. Next question that I will take is one of the important type. 5 to the power n plus 3, 5 to the power n plus 3 minus 16 into 5 to the power n plus 1 by 12 into 5 to the power n minus 2 into 5 to the power n plus 1. So when you have to solve this type of sum, so here I will use the product law. I can write 5 to the power n into 5 to the power 3 minus 16 into 5 to the power n into 5 to the power 1. So it is 5 to the power n plus 1. This is also 5 to the power n plus 3 whole divided by 12 into 5 to the power n minus 2. Here again product law, you use 5 to the power n into 5 to the power 1. Now you can see 5 to the power n, you can take common in the numerator. 5 to the power n, if you are taking common, then residual is 5 to the power 3 minus 16 into 5. Then here also you can take 5 to the power n common, present in both as factor. So 5 to the power n, so here it is 12 minus 2 into 5. Correct. Now this 5 to the power n, 5 to the power n is cancelled, so it is 125 minus 80 by 12 minus 10. So this is equal to 45 by 2, that is equal to 22.5. Next one type of question, x to the power 1 by 3 minus x to the power minus 1 by 3, x to the power 2 by 3 plus 1 plus x to the power minus 2 by 3. Now you have to solve this question, you have to simplify it. So what I am taking, I will take x to the power 1 by 3 is equal to a, and x to the power minus 1 by 3 is equal to b. So you see it is a minus b whole into, or first let me write once again, x to the power 1 by 3 minus x to the power minus 1 by 3. Then here I am writing, you see how I am writing x to the power 1 by 3 to the power 2, correct? And this is plus 1, I am not writing at present. This is x to the power minus 1 by 3 to the power 2. So it is coming x to the power 2 by 3. Now 1 I will write as x to the power 1 by 3 into x to the power minus 1 by 3. X to the power minus 1 by 3. Okay. So, what happens here? Now you substitute for x to the power 1 by 3 and x to the power minus 1 by 3. Then this is a, this is b, then this is a square plus ab plus b square. Then it is a cube minus b cube. A minus b into a square plus ab plus b square is the formula for a cube minus b cube. Now you put the value. What is a value? X to the power 1 by 3 to the power 3 minus what is b power b's value? X to the power minus 1 by 3 to the power 3. So you are getting x to the power 1 by 3 into 3 minus x to the power minus 1 by 3 into 3. So 3 cancel, here 3 cancel. You are getting x minus x to the power minus 1. So this is equal to, this is equal to x minus 1 by x. That is your answer. Another type of simplification, you see that a plus b plus c by a to the power minus 1, b to the power minus 1 plus b to the power minus 1, c to the power minus 1 plus c to the power minus 1, a to the power minus 1. So it is getting, you are getting a plus b plus c by 1 by a into 1 by b plus 1 by b into 1 by c plus 1 by c into 1 by a. So a plus b plus c, and here if you take LCM in the denominator part, so it will come abc, abc. Then here it will be c, here it will be a, and here it will be b. But now you take the reverse part, a plus b plus c into abc. So that is divided by, it is c plus a plus b, you can write it as a plus b plus c. So it is cancelled, you are getting as abc. Now few questions I will do so that you can know how to get the values of x, that is solve part. So far I had done simplification, solve part. So root over 3 by 5, root over 3 by 5 whole to the power x minus 1 is equal to given 27 by 125 whole to the power minus 1. Solve means you have to get the value of x. So I can write 3 by 5 to the power half to the power x minus 1, and it is negative 1, so I will change it 125 by 27 to the power 1. So it is 3 by 5 to the power 1 by 2, so it will be x minus 1 by 2 is equal to, now if I am taking 125 by 27 to the power 1, I have changed the negative power. So what happens, that bases are not coming equal. So I will keep the base same on both sides. In order to do that, I will keep this one as 27 by 125 to the power minus 1. Now 3 by 5 to the power x minus 1 by 2 is equal to, this is 3 to the power 3 and 5 to the power 3 to the power minus 1. So 3 by 5 to the power x minus 1 by 2 is equal to 3 by 5 to the power minus 1 into 3, so it is minus 3, because you will take the power law, no? 3 by 5 to the power whole to the power 3 to the power minus 1, so 3 will get multiplied. Now you equate, since the bases are same, so x minus 1 by 2 is equal to minus 3, So x minus 1 is equal to minus 3 into 2. So x is equal to minus 6 plus 1, that is equal to minus 5. Now one more question I would like to tell you. 2 to the power in ka kya hua iska, 2 to the power x is equal to in khatam ho gaya re, 3 to the power y is equal to 12 to the power z. So if I have to find out its 12 to the power z, then you have to show, question is show 1 by z is equal to 1 by y plus 2 by x. 2 by x. So here we have to prove 2 to the power x is equal to 3 to the power y is equal to 12 to the power z. This is given. You have to show 1 by z is equal to 1 by y plus 2 by x. So I am telling you, you can write down in your copy. It is little bit hazy. Now this type of question, what we will do, we will take 2 to the power x is equal to 3 to the power y is equal to 12 to the power z is equal to, we will consider any number that is k, say. Then each of this equal to k, 2 to the power x is equal to k, then I have told you how to transfer the power, 2 is equal to k to the power 1 by x. Similarly, 3 to the power y is equal to k, it implies 3 is equal to k to the power 1 by y. And 12 to the power z is equal to k, this implies 12 is equal to k to the power 1 by z. Now you know that 12 is equal to 4 into 3. So, or it is also equal to 2 into 3. So, 12 is equal to 2 to the power 2 into 3. 4 is 2 to the power 2. Now, 12 is here. I have got 12 is equal to k to the power 1 by z. So, put it here. K to the power 1 by z is equal to 2. 2 is k to the power 1 by x. So it is k to the power 1 by x whole to the power 2 into 3. 3 is k to the power 1 by y.